Please welcome Jean-Michel Jarre.
Hi, nice to meet you. Thank you.
Great to have you on the show.
Thank you for inviting me.
we've been talking about the Eurovision Song Contest. You're familiar with that, right?
Yes, I'm quite familiar. I like any European, I suppose, even beyond Europe now. But as a French musician, we've not been very good at Eurovision the past century, I think. And it's probably because it's so expensive that the French television is smart enough not choosing the right,
not to win
the right singer and not to win every year. So you're going to... I just heard your song and I think that you are going to pay for another year. He's going to win.
I don't know what to say.
What kind of advice would you give a 17-year-old boy that should decide whether to become an artist or not?
I mean, maybe two advice. The first one would be don't listen to any advice, and do what you want, and and be yourself. And the second one is, I think it's your priority in life is to be happy. Don't become an artist, because being an artist is a kind of addiction. You have no other choice than just following your obsession until you die. So I'm sorry, I don't want to be too dark, but it's that. I mean, I always considered, I mean, doing music or doing a movie or writing a book like a mixture of frustration and hope. The frustration that you can do better, and the hope that next time it will be maybe less worse that you've done.
And have you been unhappy yourself?
Yes, a lot. I mean, after every when I have to finish and to end an album, I'm always thinking it's not the right time and I should go back to the studio. So it's a strange thing. But actually, obviously, being an artist is a big privilege as well. So I wish you the best. And if you are hesitating between becoming a doctor, I thought, or an artist, you should think twice.
Oh, yeah.
Doctor is not bad.
Can you try to describe, because you describe yourself as well as a sound geek, can you try to put into word what sound is?
You know, I always considered music as cooking. I mean, cooking frequencies and waveforms and sounds and loops and beats. Actually, when you see a DJ these days, I mean, it's like in front of his oven. I mean, cooking beats and loops and rhythm. So it's a very organic approach. It's not. I mean, lots of people are considering sometimes electronic music as being abstract, and I think it's exactly the reverse. It's very sexual almost.
The music.
The music and the way you compose, the way you are actually creating loops and sounds and composing music. I mean, you know, electronic music.
Please explain the link here. when you say sexual or sensual.
You like that? I noticed. Well, yes.
It's at least it's very understandable. I mean, it's.
Sorry,
not more than other people. I mean, it's...
Yeah. I agree.
But it's about emotions, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, it's about the organic approach of sounds and music. I mean, the fact that you are, the main difference between electronic music and the way we were doing music before is actually you're not dealing only with notes and based on solfeggio, but you are dealing with sounds and like cooking. I mean, mixing ingredients and textures and colors and depth in a very intuitive and very sensual way.
So when you stand there with your huge laser harp, and you have like an audience of millions, then you have control over many people's emotions. Is that what you're saying?
No, you are totally out of control. anyway.
Are you?
You try to pretend that you are in control, but it's the beauty of it, the beauty of performance on stage is when you can forget the technique, when you can just, and by the end of the day, if you are in a studio like here with a few people or with lots of a big audience, it's by the end of the day the same chemistry between two entities, the audience on one side and the stage on the other side, and it works or it doesn't, and it's not a matter of technique. It's magic. It's what I prefer. I mean, I love working in studio, but the performance is something absolutely unique.
But working with music is an emotional thing, and as is acting. And you've been married to actresses, right, in your life?
Yeah.
Can it be too much emotions?
Yes, absolutely. The reason why that now I'm taking some distance with actresses. Because it's a bit too emotional. I agree. I would agree with this.
when except from on stage, or... First of all, the laser harp, will that have the same effect on women as they say guitars has?
You know, I'm still wondering. And I may, for the next tour, I'm going to play just a bit of guitar just in case. It's true, actually.
You are?
Yes.
Jaime Gérard, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
Sweden's, especially Stockholm, is very important or historic for me because my best rival, my great friend Bjorn Borg, we first played here in Stockholm in 1978. So I've been coming here for 38 years now. So I can't believe I'm still playing tennis.